We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Join the Vonn, 3 p.m. Pacific, each and every Friday for Los Angeles Today. Purple nights and golden days. Ooh, wee, he's so LA.
What up, LA? It's Mr. Vonn inviting you to join me every Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific, for Los Angeles Today.
Coming live and direct from LA Talk Live. Entertainment, sports, special guests, current events, and the hottest and latest in LA.
World belongs.
This is where the twist goes down daily. Boss up with us. Boss up with us each and every Friday on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes R&B or check us out live on LATalks.com. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talks Live, and we're more than just talk.
What up? What up? It's Friday again, and we back with Los Angeles Today. We got a very, very special show for y'all. It's really going down. We got Friday Night Live, and we back again on LA Talk Live, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. We are more than just talk. Now check this out. I got a special co-host with me, B Rich.
Hey, what's up? Los Angeles.
That's right. And we got a special guest, Alyson Campbell, PR for y'all.
What's up, everybody?
It's going down. Hey, now look. I always got to say something about this cat Trump, man. He's bombing everything. He's going crazy. He done dropped the biggest bomb on Afghanistan. Look, man, stock up on your water. Put some food to the side. Put some cash. Go buy you some gold.
Because right.
We don't know how it's going to go down, but we need to be prepared. And but we're going to get back to a much lighter note. I'm not going to go there right now because we're doing our special Dad Stone High Tech Learning Academy event tonight. We're raising money for that. We got iMixology, Mind Booty Soul. We got the flyest food. We got Breeze Cakes. It's really going down. Y'all see that? 1417 Studio 11, 4621 Washington in L.A. on Washington Boulevard, man. Be there, be square. It's going down tonight. Going down.
I'm just doing some social posts up in here for you guys because I am loving the studio.
She cannot help it. She
gonna keep enough.
It's in her veins.
Exactly. That PR. Now look, you gotta this lady, Alyson, we got a little something on her with a combined 12 years of experience.
Wow.
Relationship, international CEO, founder of Heart and Soul PR Inc.
It's going down.
She done got all kind of awards and working with nonprofits. We about to hire her right now.
Oh, I can't wait.
I'm gonna pull a Don Corleone on her. She only gonna have one client. That's it.
I love it. That's all I need. Don Corleone.
Yeah, one client.
Pizza,
that's it.
Everything.
Exactly.
We got it.
It's going down. We just gonna do it the Mr. Vonn Los Angeles way today,
yes,
though. That's it.
I love it. Keep me hot with those pizza pies and Don Corleone.
You know how we gonna do
sitting
it.
Sitting pretty.
So man, tell us, how did you get into the PR business?
Oh, man, it's a journey, my friend, isn't it? Life's a journey, right?
Life is a journey.
You know, so I think we all have a really unique story. And I'm just so, just first off, grateful for you guys having me on air here today. Not only is this a fly, amazing studio you've built here.
Fly Radio Rizich.
It is amazing. I have amazing power people around me. And you guys, my friend Veronica Rich here, who is awesome. And we got a chance to meet and really synergize this past year.
Exactly.
And I just feel very grateful to be here. So I first off want to say that before I go into the journey part, because
I think it's
all about the present to how we've got to this moment.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And
definitely.
Every moment in time is one to be
cherished.
I couldn't
have thought of a better person than you.
Aww.
Thank
you. First person that came on.
Exactly.
I call Alyson.
Well, I super appreciate that.
I put V on the spot, too. I said, I just threw her in the fire, too.
Oh, he did.
I said, we're going to get out. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Yeah. V is fly too, ain't she?
She's so fly. We were just talking. The girl's got style. She's got music. You really should stand up so everybody can see the full scale outfit here. She's got some chucks in here.
No.
I came and I said,
when I walked in, he was already talking about something.
No,
oh,
no,
you
no,
just
no,
be like
no, 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 no. She had to wait.
I'm like, what you mean?
No, she had to correct me though. She said,
"Nah, nah."
She said,
nah,
"This
nah.
is V Rich. V is different from V Rich."
I had to let him
yeah,
back.
That's her alter ego.
Right,
like Beyonce got Sasha Fierce.
Sasha Fierce, yeah.
V Rich come in, you know.
Man, with them crazy flows too.
Yes,
though.
Yes. I actually met her. Do you know how we met?
No.
On a red carpet at my birthday party, because that's how I roll. Yep. You know, but that
red
that,
carpet birthday party.
I did a red carpet birthday party.
No red carpet.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right. That's how we do it.
But it was about celebrating everybody. You know, I wanted to celebrate all my friends. It wasn't about me. Yeah, birthdays are about a lot of people, right? And, you know, oh, I want it to be me. Bring me gifts. No, no, no. You guys will know. Heart and Soul is all about supporting other people.
Heart and Soul. I love that name.
And how I can be a voice for someone
else. You
know,
we got a lot of questions for
you. Ooh, I can't wait.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so we met and all stylish, and she's stylish. And
yeah, it was just a match made in heaven.
Yes.
And you're a fitness exercise trainer and all that too.
Yes, sir. Cycle, right. Zumba, Pound. We're going to launch Pound Workout with V here. We're going to do an amazing summer event, so stay tuned for that too.
That's right.
Super,
that's
super
right.
excited.
That's right. You got a lot going
a
on.
A lot going, but staying on.
You're
the
overachiever
focus.
Too, huh?
Always been.
That's right. I love to surround myself with overachievers. You know, we get the job done.
Yes, sir.
No matter what.
That's right.
So, Alyson, what made you get into PR?
The PR journey, my friend, is a very interesting one. So we'll start back there, right? Because we talked about journeys at the top of this broadcast, right? So I think the biggest thing is I went to school for journalism. So I'm I love writing. You know, that's my thing. I was in this path of I'm going to be a journalist. I'm going to be a newspaper editor. I'd written for my newspaper in high school, you know, all this stuff, right? And I was the overachiever, doing tons of stuff in college, involved in dance and music and student senate and all these organizations, right? But then I had a roommate that said, well, Alyson, there's this PR meeting happening on campus. I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, you know, I can't get involved in anything else. Like,
I'm already up to my eyeballs.
Right. Yeah, right?
And that's when we take on one more thing.
Exactly. So you know what? But it's about being open, right? It's about being open to opportunities and experiences. And I think that's what's really important too. So I said, all right, let me see what this is about. At least a meeting isn't gonna hurt me. Fine, I'll go check this out. I was kind of hooked on this whole vibe of the fact that I could merge my writing talents, the creative aspect of PR, you know, just like the people, you know, clearly I'm a talker, I'm an outgoing gal, but you know, I love creating that synergy between people. I've always loved that. I've always been this connector, little chameleon, you know, of sorts, so I can kind of just vibe with any type of person.
That's right. I can see that. You came in and got right with us.
Right with it, you know.
I got some ideas, you know, PR. I said, we're going to blow it up. The studio's fly.
That's
I'm feeling good. Exactly.
Yes, sir.
And I see you got some fly clients too.
Yes. Well,
wow.
And thank you. And that was a journey, but you
Mercedes
know, so
Mercedes Benz,
rolling in style, sir.
New York
you know?
Fashion Week.
New
that's
York
big.
Fashion Week.
New York Fashion Week.
So tell us about what you did for Mercedes-Benz.
Yeah, for sure. Well, and if you don't mind, I'll back up a little bit on that, because I want to say too, you know, our paths don't always have to be this carved out, like I have to have it all perfect, right? I have to have it all figured out, because people say, oh, but you jumped from journalism to PR. Like, how was that shift? And I had never had any PR experience. I was able to apply the media skills that I learned in school towards the PR, which only made me a better professional.
Right. But they're similar. They're actually similar.
Yeah. They're similar. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
I always say trust the journey.
Trust the journey.
Oh,
I love that.
Yes. Because the journey,
Lord
knows, takes endurance.
It takes endurance.
Sure
does.
It takes endurance.
Yeah, I always say this is not a sprint. It's a marathon.
She's up in here.
I start
gospel.
Preaching to you. You
yes.
know it. You know it. You know it.
Well, Mercedes-Benz was a very cool experience because they were the primary sponsor for Fashion Week in New York for a long time. But I plugged myself in there kind of on this volunteer level to start. Mm-hmm. Our firm wasn't really doing a lot of work with them at the time. But I said, I've always been this style queen like Miss Veronica here. I've always enjoyed style. And I wanted to get involved. So I started with a program at the Fashion Institute of Technology in New York. And they have a really cool certificate program where once once you already have your, you know, bachelor's or other degree, you can get an ongoing certificate. And I said, all right, I'm going to do this fashion events thing, see what it's all about. I love fashion. Mm-hmm. So I jumped in and I was doing crazy things like styling, you know, models. And by styling, it sounds sexy, but really it was keep the tie on and walk the runway, you know. Come on, dude.
You got in where you could fit in.
Correct. Exactly. Absolutely. Yeah. And then that evolved, right? And this
find
whole
a
journey.
Way or make one. That's yes. why I like that. You, sometimes you have to carve your own path.
That's
totally.
It. You gotta
totally.
Do what you gotta do.
Uh-huh. You've seen lots of stuff backstage at Fashion Week, let me tell you. It's mm-hmm. very interesting.
Very interesting.
Very interesting. And then, you know, then I went on to okay, she really knows
what
she's doing.
What
are
some of the most interesting stuff? I know you can't tell too Ooh. Much. But you know, I like to get all the tea.
All the tea.
Yeah, I like to get all the tea. I like to get all the tea.
I'm trying to think of something right offhand, but you know what I'll say is every designer is really different, right? Some of them, it's like stark silence. You could hear a pin drop backstage, right? Mm. It's like, we don't want anybody talking, and anybody talks, it's like, and then other designers, they just want chaos around them. It's just like they want to see garments flying and girls the rack going, oh, it doesn't matter if she's in the line the right way. And I'm going to go.
That's so exciting.
Yeah. Wow. Very interesting.
Very different personalities.
Yeah. Very different personalities. And especially the models, as you can imagine, you know, they
some
all have
egos,
their own. Oh, yeah.
Some divas.
Oh, yeah. And it's just put on the shoes and wear the shoes. Like, that's all you got to do and walk.
Exactly.
That's it.
Yeah.
You know.
So you got to. You were able to deal with all that.
Yeah, huh? It was really cool because it gave me the behind the scenes experience, which later on was able to then monetize some freelance work for me, which was cool. So I got a chance by doing the styling to see how the photographers move backstage, how the, you know, press, we would only let certain press to take certain shots of certain looks because we don't want all of that out there to everybody. We wanted some exclusive shots, you know, how we would invite press backstage. I did some front of house. Who gets to sit where?
Oh,
it's a
okay.
science, my friends. You know, you got to have a good look. People in the front row.
Science of PR. Exactly.
Absolutely.
So you basically were buffers. You were like, not this here, not that
Absolutely.
There, do this there.
Oh, yeah. You got an empty seat in the front row. You better say, oh, there's a Veronica. Let me put her right there in that chair because
right.
there's.
We want everything to
Everything's
got to
look right.
Cool.
Yeah.
And you got a very diverse client from Mercedes Benz to the Girl Scouts of America.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
That's interesting.
It's been an interesting wheelhouse, I would say, because I had a chance to really grow up in my first agency in New York City, which is where I started, right out of school.
NY, shout out
yes,
to the NY.
Yes, NYC. And I'll see you next week, NYC, because I'm headed there.
Exactly.
I always have, you know, New York's my heart, right? But it's an interesting thing, right? Because this journey that evolved, you know, I was like, grew up in this agency 7 years. So I had a chance to work on all these kind of different industries, which was great. So from fashion, like you were saying, to, you know, nonprofit work. You know, did a lot of beauty work, luxury markets, you know, a lot of different things I got a chance to get my hands really wet with and really grow with.
So at that time, were you working for someone else or did you start off having your own company?
Oh, that would have been cool, right? But no, I started off working for someone else
exactly.
for almost 10 years of my career before launching my own business.
You hear that, y'all? You got to pay your dues. You got to pay your dues.
You do.
So what eventually made you start your own company?
That's an awesome question and one that I love to answer because I think it's all, again, goes back to this journey piece, right? So you need to have the experience under your belt. You want to have those relationships, in my case, with the business, which is everything. So before I could do something like that, I've always been this entrepreneurial-minded self-starter. We were talking about kind of this overachiever. But, you know... Clearly, you guys are the same way. You know, we want to be out there in a big way. So how can I do this? But it wasn't about the visibility for me to start. I said, I want to create a place where clients can come that will be able to have great services in PR and really get the expertise that they need without the huge agency dollars that go into these campaigns, right? So
more like a family.
More like a family and also being able to service kind of, I don't want to call it the underdog, but the smaller business owners and brands that were up and coming or are up and coming that can't afford $3,000, $4,000 or $5,000 plus agency dollars to do what they need to do in business.
Mm-hmm. That was a great business model though, because if you come in and prove what you're doing, and grow that company, they're going to be loyal to you. That's building long-term clientele base that every time they come back to you and they're like, we're going to use heart and soul.
Yes, sir. Yeah. And I pride myself on that, you know, and right. I think that's what it's about, you know, for all of our businesses, right? You have a great reputation, you build great relationships. Mm-hmm. And
relationship is everything.
Oh, everything.
Relationships, relationships. How to be so a boss. Relationships.
Boss.
Create lasting relationships.
So I guess you put your heart and soul in every promotion?
I do.
Is that how that worked out?
Putting the heart and soul and partnering with like-minded people who have that heart
exactly.
and soul mentality as
great.
Well.
Right. Exactly.
Boss lady is the hat I was going to wear in, but, you know, I didn't have time to grab that off my shelf, but that's, you know, the hat.
You got a boss lady? Yeah.
Boss lady.
You got a boss lady. Boss.
Shout out to Mother Trucker.
I need one of those.
Those boss ladies, Mother Trucker, launched in Orange County, and they got on a Good Morning America and all these great
wow.
things that
wow.
I've seen now, but they're blinged out, kind of sequined hats, really cool stuff going on.
Okay.
But a boss lady, that's
the
that's
entrepreneur.
Like
another
that.
Entrepreneur.
Yeah. Yeah, we might have to track them down.
Right, oh, yeah. Right.
Exactly.
Yeah. So if there was one thing that you could tell young entrepreneurs that are just starting, what would you tell them in their business?
Young entrepreneurs.
How to
yes.
be successful.
I love that question because I think it's all about growth and learning, and you're not always going to have it figured out, and you're not always going to have mm-hmm. it right. That's the biggest thing.
It's so discouraging at times. You're like,
it
get
is.
It. I'm over this.
Yes.
But my father told me after difficulty comes ease.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Mm. So, you know, you got to keep putting one foot in front of the other. And keep
I like
going.
That. Yes, keep pushing. Yeah. And there's going to be those obstacles, and there's going to be those things you don't get right. And I think that's where people get stuck because they think, I have to have it all figured out. I have to do it right. And it's like, well, okay, you're going to do what you do. And there might be some steps that are wrong, and you'll course correct later, but you're never going to have all the steps perfectly. And I think that's great. And that's, I have a podcast as well. So I talk
what?
To up and coming.
She said, I got a podcast too. That's
and
right.
I learn a lot from people, though, too, that I talk to.
You know
that
what?
That,
I want to go back to what you said. That's a really good point. Everything's not going to be perfect.
Yeah.
And I think that's what makes people get so discouraged sometimes when they're starting a business or just starting to branch out on something new. Is you're
totally.
Like, oh, this didn't happen immediately when I thought it was going to happen. Or I feel like I failed at this. But what is it, like the average millionaire? How many times do they fail before they become
at
successful?
At least 7 or 8.
Yeah.
Oh, my
at least.
Goodness.
Yeah.
You learn from your failures. That's
right.
how you learn how to
yeah,
win.
Yeah, that's how you learn. Through
you
imperfection.
Make this mistake,
imperfection
you make that
is beautiful.
Mistake.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
And then not only that, you need for the stars to align with you.
Yeah, that too.
You know, you need for the stars to align.
A little
lucky way. Yeah. You need a little bit of that too. Yeah.
Yes.
Success
I think
is
all
when,
of that. Yes.
Success is when preparation and planning come together, you know, with a little bit of luck.
Yes, sir.
That right there, that
absolutely.
Part.
And then the power of prayer. Because, you know, you spending those nights thinking about, hey, how am I going to get this? How am I going to get that?
Yeah.
I want this. And then it's also speaking what you want into existence, too.
I agree. Mm-hmm. Law of attraction.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yes. So. 48 laws. Great. I love these great minds all gathered here
great
at LA
minds
Talk
think alive.
Woo!
Yeah.
That's right.
There's a beautiful story about this station, too.
Really?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You know, so you're surrounded with that mindset.
I
you know?
Love it.
This whole thing started in a house and
wow.
grew from here.
Wow.
And a lot of sacrifice, a lot of sweat and tears, you know. You know, the philosophy is, you know, the broadcasters own the station. We're the ones who make this. So
wow.
You know what I mean? So this
boss.
Is a boss.
Boss.
Exactly.
Boss.
Everybody,
boss.
Everybody bosses up.
Woo.
That's how we do it. Shout outs to the marijuologists that started the whole thing.
That's right.
Please believe it.
You got the power colors up in here, too. All the red.
Yeah, exactly. Because
yes.
we all about the power, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, power for the people.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
That
we don't get censored. You know what I mean?
Right.
We can censor ourselves, you know, but, you know, we get to have our platform, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a partnership that means something, you know.
Yeah,
definitely.
That's what this about. V Rich is going to be doing some stuff, too. So,
yeah,
V Rich.
I've got
she
a
got
few
up
your
sleeve.
Well, you know, she's an artist, a producer,
oh,
an
yeah.
actor, a writer.
Mm-hmm.
She does a bunch of stuff. So,
I'm trying, you know.
Yeah.
I'm telling you. You throw everything in the pot, some gonna stick.
Exactly.
It's gonna make a good jambalaya, that's
stick.
For sure.
Or some gumbo.
Yes.
You just make some gumbo.
That gumbo be banging up.
Banging.
Be a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Be all seasoned up, all
exactly.
flavored, all the aroma. It's just good.
And it tastes good. Yeah.
Ooh, now we're talking about food and I'm
oh,
hungry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But you know what? I think that everything really piggybacks off the next thing. You know, it's all about being a creative person and having a creative mind and thinking outside of the box and not being afraid to actually try say new things and new endeavors because, like, eventually that's, I mean, that's what happens. That's how you become successful in business. Totally. That's how you become rich, you know?
So Alyson, yes. I was thinking about a scenario, right? Uh-huh. So you get a client and you yeah. come in and they have this whole idea about how their PR is supposed to go, right?
Uh-huh.
And you're listening to them and you're like, no, that's not going to work. I know that's happened. Look, she's laughing.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Like, well, yeah. So what is your approach to bring them back and ground them in reality?
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a great question because I think, you know, that's so much of what we're faced with. And my friend pointed this out to me. We were talking the other day. It's like the human psychology of kind of understanding how the mind goes and how the people work and how to communicate that because it's all about how you communicate it, right? So you could say, oh, you were wrong. That's not going to work. And that's not going to get you very far. That's going to get you fired.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. More people need to hear that. That is so, it's not what you say, it's how you say it.
I had to learn that the hard way.
I'm still learning.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, V will put something in your Bluetooth.
Yeah. So it's, yeah, it's all in the how. And so I think once you've gotten into the mindset and really understood, I ask a lot of questions too of my clients up front, you know, really tell me your story. Mm. Tell me what you see. I'm only an extension of you and you are the expert and I'm here to help carry that out for you. Wow, so that's how I approach it.
That's how you approach it.
Yeah.
And that's created your success.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
For sure.
So you can't just come in and tell them, no.
All right.
Fuck you. I'm just playing out of it.
Yes, there is a lot of expectation management. That's a big part of what we do. You know, got to get the heads out of the cloud a little bit, but you can definitely work it. And it's all in how you communicate it.
So you got a, do you have PR packages or you just create a customized, promotion or PR for each firm that you come in contact with or each client?
Yeah, now we're getting into the science. So you're going down a big rabbit hole here, but I like the question. So we'll just say this. It's custom for every client because, I mean, every client's different, right? And I think, like I said earlier, the chance that I've had to work in a lot of different industries has allowed me to see kind of how each different industry moves a little bit. Each different person obviously moves a little bit differently. So you want to be able to customize it based on their goals. That's why I always will just sit down and she'll tell you we've even had like coffee and wrapped and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, well, she really raps, so you know. But I can kind of rap.
Right. You have a background in music.
I do have a background in music.
Wow. So
yes.
How does that translate to your PR? Because you work with a lot of people in music.
I do.
Well, right?
I've had the fortune of working with some really cool artists in music as well, and it's been really cool because they see, oh, in fact, shout out to Anthony King and Apollo Kids. I'm gonna be seeing them in Harlem next week. We're getting ready for a big launch.
Nice.
Wow.
I can't say the name, but you all will hear about it, and we'd love to talk to you about that after we get live with that. But yeah, it's been cool because it translates, hey, I know the music and creative side as a musician. I know how you guys work in that space, but then I can tell your message on the communication side, which has been really fun.
Right.
Wow. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yes.
So how do you incorporate your clients into the whole social media thing?
Because well,
I have a few platforms and what I'm seeing now is that if you can build and control your social media organically or otherwise, it could really translate into dollars for you.
Huge. I mean, social is where it's at. And if you're not on social, as we all know, then it's pretty much, you know, the business is going to die at some point, right? You know, keeping up with the times and, you know, the signs of the times and all those things, right, they say. But that's been an interesting thing in growing in my journey in PR is seeing all the tools evolve. And I've been what people call like the early adopter, right? Seeing Twitter before like it just started and having to jump on all these platforms and really know the ins and outs of it. That's the other big part as a PR professional is seeing, okay, how can I move with this platform? How can my clients possibly work in this platform? Make sure I understand all the nuts and bolts of it too. Because if I got to make those recommendations, then I got to understand, you know, how this is going to work and maybe not all those platforms are going to work. Because I think I'll say that too. And social media is a whole big conversation as we can say, right? But to your point, you could do it well. You can really monetize and really grow your brand and do it the right way and speak to your consumer or your target audience in the right way. That's really where the bread and butter is. Like right. You know,
so what do you think about the new, like, advertisements that they're offering, like the Facebook ads, the Instagram ads,
like the sponsored posts, all
that
kind of stuff?
Worth it, or?
Yeah, I mean, I think now it's become a completely integrated marketing mix, and my business partner will tell you this, which is why I partnered at the beginning of this year with someone who's very steeped in that space, that's in that
in the
marketing
social media
mix.
Space?
Social media and, you know, the paid media piece, right?
Okay.
Because I do what's called earned media. People say, what's PR? Earned. And I say earned because I have the relationships, and then I pitch the stories to, say, different press outlets, and then they cover the artist or the topic or the brand or the product, right? Now, advertising, I can just say, all right, I'm going to throw a couple grand at something, and oh, I have a beautiful color ad, but I don't really know what my return on investment or ROI is going to be on that, right? Because, oh, okay, all these people might have seen the insert, or they might have thrown it out in the recycle too, you know, right? Versus PR, which is I can see, okay, at least if I can get something printed about my clients, or, you know, even via social shout out, especially by an influencer, since we're talking about the social space, then I know my message is going to carry that much further.
Mm. Wow.
That makes sense.
So you've incorporated the social media into your whole PR as part of your business model now.
It has to be. Absolutely. They're just one and the same, really. I mean, they're so linked in the sense of everything that has to roll hand in hand.
You hear that out there?
Yes.
Because I tell people that, and they're like, oh, I don't want to be on Facebook, or I don't want to be on Instagram, I don't want
to
do this, and I'm like, man, how are you gonna how are you gonna make it?
It's right. Like, you don't exist anymore.
Right.
Exactly. What do you think about Snapchat?
That's funny. Well, I think Snapchat, and I'll just talk about it from the business perspective, because I mean, we could all just, you know, waste a lot of time and, you know, have fun on these apps and all that kind of stuff. But Snapchat is an interesting market. I think they have to evolve a little bit. You know, they had the whole IPO thing that went down. I mean, I think they're in kind of a state of flux, but they're definitely growing, right? And so it's not a medium you can ignore. And I think it's now stretching beyond just the teen market, which is where it started, right? Which is like, okay, you saw your teens and tweens
with
it.
You can send
it.
Those sexy pictures.
Exactly. Have you heard of Awesomeness TV?
I have. In fact, shout out to Awesomeness TV.
Exactly.
Sure,
so, you know, they're a
$650
million company. And I bought Snapchat because of what one of the founders of that company said.
Yeah.
He said Snapchat was one of the most innovative companies that were going to come up, and they're just in their infancy of evolving into what they're going to be into. So I just went and bought like 600 shares.
Now what?
Boss Angeles.
Boss Angeles. If you don't own something, then what can you do?
Right.
Be an owner. Think like a boss.
I like
that's
that.
Why he
tagline
always
tagline that right yeah. there. Be an, yeah. Say that again. That was a good
be
one.
Be an owner. Uh-huh. Think like a boss.
Yeah.
You know how
that
we get
part.
Out.
One. That part.
You know how we get out. But you know what though? We're going to go to break.
Okay.
Right here, and we're going to bring Nikko London in, and we're going to talk about his book, Entertainment, Sex, and Lies, which y'all know about that. And we're going to incorporate that with a PR twist.
Hey.
We got V Rich, we got Alyson, and you got your host, Mr. Vonn, on LA Talk Live every 3 p.m. Pacific Fridays.
Running your house for the pack, yeah. Shoot up for that where you at, yeah. Kicking your door for the cat, yeah. I go to war for the cat, yeah. Hey, had to run it up, hey, had to run it up, hey, had to run it up, hey, had to run it up. You ain't got my money, what the fuck? You mean? You know I need my money, boy, don't fuck with me. Good looking, kinda weird. They keep playing with my dough.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
What's up? This is James Shipp inviting you to join us every Wednesday at 7 p.m. for Ballers World Live, where we're talking basketball and bullshit. So don't forget, tune in to Ballers World Live every Wednesday at 7 p.m. exclusively on latalklive.com and the America Talk Live Broadcast Network. You can also catch us on Ustream and YouTube, and now live on Facebook, or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk.
Join the Vonn, 3 p.m. Pacific. each and every Friday from Los Angeles today. Purple nights and golden days. Ooh wee, he's so LA.
What up, LA? It's Mr. Vonn inviting you to join me every Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific, for Los Angeles today.
Coming live and direct from LA Talk Live. Entertainment, sports, special guests, current events, and the hottest and latest in LA.
World belongs to us.
This is where the twist goes down daily. Boss up with us. Boss up with us each and every Friday on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes R&B or check us out live on LA Talks. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talks Live, and we're more than just talk.
Hi, this is WDC.
And this is Robert Lamar.
Inviting you to join us every Saturday, 2 p.m. Pacific, for Scholar Me Live.
Join us as we bring you weekly sports highlights,
interviews with student athletes, coaches and pros,
song of the week,
contest giveaways,
Scholar Me Female and Male Students of the Week.
So don't forget to tune into the number one social network,
the sporty and sexy Scholar Me Live, Saturdays, 2 p.m. Pacific,
exclusively on LATalkLive.com
and the American Talk Live Broadcast Network.
Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure.
This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Wanting.
For fun and fashions, and they wanna have some. They say I'm handsome, stole her heart, no ransom. Now how you feel about the new Benz? Few friends, eat good, nightlife, party on the rooftop. Too sexy for you motherfucking lames. Fly venues, tens that I attend to. Order anything on the sex.
What's up? We back again. We got a special guest in the house on LA Talk Live, Los Angeles today. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. We back with V Rich, Alyson. We got Nikko London in the house.
Nikko London in the building. What's up, y'all?
What's up? Actor, rapper,
entrepreneur.
Author. Man, we teamed up on him now.
We got the boss.
What's up? We going to seal the deal with the Seal the Deal book.
We're going to seal the deal with Seal.
Entertainment and lies.
Woo!
It's crazy. It's crazy.
Saucy.
He got
saucy.
Man,
he got saucy to follow.
Yeah, lies and lawsuits. The hell is going on, man? What possessed you to write a book like that and put everybody on blast?
Oh, man. I mean, you know. It's 20 years of my life in the book.
That's right. That's right. That's a lifetime.
I felt it was necessary. I mean, honestly, my agent called me one day. My booking agent, he called me.
That's right.
So he said, yo, I got a deal for you. And I said, it would make sense that we can go into it. But I got all this other stuff I'm doing. And that's how it happened, man. The book just came about.
Another overachiever.
Yeah. Yes.
We're going to call it the overachiever.
That's exactly what
it is. Get down for the get down. Yeah. You understand me?
Yeah, I took advantage of that moment.
That's right. That opportunist. So. I feel it.
Yeah, you know.
Man, we're PR and sex.
That did my deal. Ingram's.
Oh, okay.
Ingram's one of the biggest publication companies out there. I did a great deal with them. Shout out to Ingram's.
It sounded like it was good. You got a big smile on your face.
Yeah, I did a good.
We ain't gonna tell, but man, it sounded like it was good.
Yeah, I did a great deal with them. No upfront money, but I did the split deal. You know, I'm about the backing deal.
Man, that's
if you believe in yourself, do the deal
that's the better money.
Do the deal that's gonna make sense for the rest of your life.
Invest in yourself like a boss.
Invest in yourself like a boss. Absolutely.
Boss up.
Keep eating, not just for the day, but for tomorrow.
Yeah. So it was something that, you know, the company wanted to put a rush on, being that my name and, you know, the publicity I had from the show, from the sex tape, all this other stuff.
What's the show? Tell them the show.
Love and Hip Hop.
Love and Hip Hop.
Yeah, Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. Yeah, so most of y'all might know from the ATL, Love and Hip Hop.
The most hated man.
Yeah, the most hated man on
reality television.
Yeah.
Because so you be doing it to him, man. Why you do it to him like that, though?
I mean, we was having fun, man. You know, it just took off that way.
Man, them girls, man, you make everybody mad. Yeah. I said, man, this cat, man, you need to knock it off.
I just was being me on the show, man. I'm, you know, the villain. Like, if anyone's seen Batman, yeah. I was the Joker in the movie, so.
Exactly.
It was fun for me. It's still a fun ride. I mean, everywhere I go, people just show me nothing but love. They just want to take pictures and be like, that's that guy from, you know, they got all kind of names for me. Freako, Nico, sex tape guy. So, you know, I get approached in the streets, man. People be calling my name. I be really thinking I know them. Like, I turn around and be like,
whoa. Yeah.
Oh, no, I don't know you, but I just know you from the show, damn, man. Yo, keep doing your thing.
So, how did you get on Love & Hip Hop?
I got on Love & Hip Hop because me and Mimi had a relationship way back in the day. Maybe 13, 14 years ago.
High school.
We had something.
Wanted the tea. Yeah. That's what you said earlier, you know.
Yeah, so she was, we did our thing, and we stayed friends throughout the year. So I haven't seen her in, like, maybe 4 or 5 years.
Mm.
And we ran into each other VMA weekend at the Beverly Hills Hotel. And that's when it all went down.
That's a fly hotel, too.
Right.
That's a fly hotel.
Weekend, Beverly Hills Hotel.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, they invited me the next day to dinner to Boa. And that's what it, you know.
Nice steakhouse for y'all that don't know in Beverly Hills. It goes down, too.
You know, so that's where I got recruited at. You know, they wanted to see the chemistry, the cast, you know, certain casting directors was there. So I didn't do an audition for the show at all. Like, most people go do an audition for reality TV. I didn't do it because I didn't have to. Because me and her had a chemistry already. So,
so they chose you. They chose you. They brought you out.
Yeah, I was the love interest for her next season. So I was going into her second season of Love and Hip Hop. Okay. I was the love interest for her.
So they wrote you in.
Yeah, they wrote me in there. So
that's right.
It happened the way it happened, man. Mm-hmm. It was supposed to happen that way. I was new to TV. I didn't know anything about TV.
They wrote you. So is reality TV really reality then, or is it
it's a business. My man just said,
it's a business.
You got to pay the bills, baby.
Yeah, you got to pay the bills.
So, you know, it's you know, they got to monitor it a certain way. So, you know, it's 50-50.
Yeah.
But it's reality, but it's also
they make a little conflict here, a little conflict.
You know,
there.
They got to delegate the right way. So they had a bunch of, you know, black folks just running crazy and doing what they wanted to do. It wouldn't be a show.
Right. Exactly.
So they had to monitor it that way. So do
the things that we see, like, on Love & Hip Hop, does it really go down like that, or is it more into the creative editing?
Wow, those are the secrets everyone wants to know.
You want
to
know.
I know.
Los
Angeles today.
Are you really the villain, or did they edit you to be the villain? Which one is it?
No, Nico's a villain.
He's a bad villain.
I mean, I could tell it to you like this. When you meet me in person, you're going to see a whole different demeanor. So you're going to TV is TV, and then in person is in person.
Okay, exactly.
So am I really the villain? Absolutely not. But on TV, as the character, absolutely yes.
Yeah. Mm.
So that's how we got to. That's how we got to paint that picture. That's really what it is. But when you meet me, you're gonna be like, "Wow, this guy was nothing like the TV painted him." So you could draw your own conclusion from that. But everything is in the book. So if you get the book, you're gonna find out
the
everything.
Book. And where can we all get the
saucy
stuff? Where can we get the book? Tell them where to get the book at.
Barnes and Nobles, Amazon.
Oh man,
it's on a bunch of different links that I don't even know. But I got it written down in my memo somewhere. They sent it to me and they told me to post this everywhere. So, but the main places to start is Barnes and Nobles and Amazon, and 5 other links at the song.
And I saw your social media. Did your book sell out?
So the book sold out. It came out on the 4th. So my book came out April 4th.
Mm-hmm.
And it sold out on Amazon the next day.
Oh wow!
Wow!
Amazing! Yeah. Congratulations!
That's amazing!
So that was congratulations! Good, like people that
you made the right deal.
Yeah,
that sound like a good
you made you, that sound like a good deal. Hey, that's better
that
than that rap money, ain't it?
Like people like literally people that ordered the book a month ago, 2 months ago, still waiting for their book.
Wow!
Oh wow!
That's crazy.
So
right?
Tell me, that's better than that rap money, though, ain't it?
It's better than the rap money because let me say it like this. It's more of a residual income, right? So you can eat off this, your kids.
Exactly.
So it's that kind of money. Like in other words, anything can go on with me in my life, right? From here on till I die, right?
And
as long as this book,
the more status I get, anything that pivots, it can pivot the book to sell another million copies.
Exactly.
I can read, you know. So the book is it's a lot of value to it in terms of not just selling out on the first day or selling out.
He created value for himself. You hear that out there? Because you know the entertainment is the entertainment business.
Absolutely.
So everybody need to understand that it's
absolutely
about having your business and your paperwork and everything
that's
together.
Right. It's about having everything together. And the music game is no real difference because in publishing, if you own your publishing, then you eat off that for the rest of your life. So you
but you know a lot of cats don't own their publishing.
Well, of course, but that's what I'm saying. But I do. I own mine.
That's
So you would tell young artists that it's better to be independent?
I would tell young artists it's way better to be independent, especially now the times that we're living in.
Exactly.
Because we're living in a time now where everything is about streaming. So if you're streaming your stuff and you hustling that grind, I could be $1,000, $500.
You know, we got a streaming company.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, we got a streaming
company.
Well,
that's good. Well, you're in the right business right now.
So, you know, we can make that happen.
That's the business model right now.
And we got the pay-per-view in front of it, too.
Okay, well, there you go. So we're going to talk off the mics about
exactly
that one.
Yeah.
And bring y'all some more boss talk when we get together.
We need to get you the Nikko London channel with your own app and everything. I can make that happen.
Let's make it happen.
I'm a tech. You ain't got to put up no money on that. I just want to be on the back end with you. That's all.
You on the back end. Listen, I'm going to tell y'all something. So now, some back-end deals is good and some back-end deals it's not. In my situation, all the back end deals that I did from the sex tape, that's a back end deal.
I saw that sex tape.
Oh wow, a lot of women seen the sex tape.
Did y'all see
I saw Ray J's.
She was up on the shower thing and he was a lot of things going on, and I was like, man, what was that like? Did you talk about that in your book?
That's in the book too.
He don't want to give up too much. He said, no, you got to keep buying this book for a minute. But you could give us a little bit though.
I want to know how that went down.
Cause Mimi ain't bad either though. Mimi ain't bad. Mimi seemed like she a little freak too.
She was throwing that thing back. I brought the freak out of her.
Oh, okay. You know how we do it.
Gas.
Yeah. I will not lose, right?
I would just say this, man. When you got a chemistry with somebody, it's just that chemistry. It might be just that for that moment, but it might just be a sex thing. But me and her was more so of a sex thing. Like we had that chemistry. That off camera, I mean, outside of the bed, it was a different chemistry.
So the tape.
But the tape.
Who really? Tell us the truth, Nikko.
Yeah, who leaked that tape?
Did y'all lose the tape? Did y'all leak the tape?
Well, you know what? For those of y'all who don't know the story and haven't been watching TV and watching Love & Hip Hop and still looking at me as being a villain, the guy that leaked the tape, it's already out there. Like, me and her plotted this. Me and her was like,
Clyde. That was a business move. Y'all tried to do the Kardashian thing, huh? Take it to the whole next level.
Well, we didn't cash out like the Kardashians. We ain't get as lucrative as they got because they mom, you know, Kardashian moms took it all the way to the $500 million, half a billion dollar.
She don't play no mark.
She ain't playing.
Me and Mimi missed the mark on a shower rod. Right there, we killed our business.
I was waiting for the shower rod.
We'd have some money. We'd have a stream. We'd even have somebody telling us.
You guys could have made a sex toy shower.
You guys could cash out right now.
Hey, it ain't over with yet.
That's the beauty. That's the money man right here. Look, he over here.
Money closer.
Well, listen,
and what else? We ain't playing around.
Well,
shower rods. Okay, we could get those. I could go to China. I could get those by the bulk.
Well, see, the good thing about
this. Some other things we could do.
Hey, so the good thing about this is. For a lot of y'all up and coming entrepreneurs and wannabe bosses out there, the good thing about me is in the whole thing that I just came through. I mean, I got a long history, but in saying that, when you say it's not over, yeah, there's some business truth to that.
Exactly.
As long as my sex symbolism keep rising, then that's
as long
I'm
as
selling.
This book is out here.
The
you
book
know?
Is out there.
Hey man, I'm gonna tell you this right here. This book right here. This is a show right here in itself.
In and of itself.
Okay. Well, let's.
This is a show right here in itself. Just so you know.
Hey, I was thinking about that
when I seen it.
I love to hear what you got in mind.
Seal the deal.
Seal the deal, baby.
Seal the deal. You understand me?
That is a show. Sex, entertainment.
Ooh.
Oh.
Hey, that Mr. Vonn, Los Angeles today, baby. Right here, Nikko London.
Vonn, we talking after the, we get off the air.
No, I'm telling
it's
you,
another
man.
Business move going down, y'all.
We gotta get the Nikko London app where they could download it with all the great, man, do the pay-per-view. Oh man, come on now.
I've been creeping on your social media. Haven't you started some type of a Nikko Talk or Talk Live?
London's
or,
way.
London's way. Oh, see,
London's way is starting over it. I've been trending that.
What is that? I saw a little piece of it, but I was like,
hey. Now, what did I just say about Snapchat? Go buy some Snapchat. I got 600
you
shares.
Did just say that.
I got 600 shares. Hey, listen, and it just went down. It's like $20.50 right now. Now listen, it was 18 and I was waiting. I was waiting. I thought it was going to go down more. Now listen, Dr. Boyce Watkins said you could spend $5 a day and change your life. But I'm just telling y'all, for y'all out there, man, go buy Snapchat. Facebook started off at $20
and now it went
140.
Yeah.
Well, I got a portfolio, baby.
Hey, listen to my man. Listen to Vonn.
Snapchat spectacles up in here.
Diversified. You understand?
That's
real
smart.
Estate, stocks, bonds, businesses.
That's smart.
We need to get the big old Snapchat
sticker.
We ain't playing around here. This ain't no game. The show ain't called Los Angeles for nothing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Los Angeles. Let's
where the
go.
Twist goes
Los
down
Angeles.
Daily.
Woo!
Purple nights and golden days.
I love it.
I'm so L.A.
West Side.
West Side?
Hey, y'all better listen to that, man. Y'all heard what you said. The stock. Yeah. Most of y'all, a lot of y'all out there in the stock, y'all better go snap some of that Snapchat stock.
You got to really understand that. You know what I'm saying?
So, Nikko, I was reading a little bit of your book, and something that stuck out to me in there was you have been portrayed as, and a lot of people know you as, an opportunist. Mm-hmm. He just mentioned opportunist.
Right.
So, but in your book, you talk about the difference between an opportunist and a hustler. What is that?
The difference between an opportunist and a hustler, to me, an opportunist is someone who sees opportunities that either brought to them by someone else, or they see it for themselves and they go after it. Mm-hmm. Now, you want to be an opportunist, because an opportunist is that doesn't mean you're taking advantage of someone. That just means you see something that somebody else, the masses, don't see.
Exactly.
And you put yourself in that environment to capitalize off of it. Mm-hmm. Doesn't mean you're taking somebody down with you. That doesn't mean you go into somebody's house and totally putting the cover over their face and psyching them out. No, that just means that I see an opportunity that can get us to this next level or get me into this next level so I can help you get into the next level.
Right.
Now, hustler is really a play off of that. So hustler is kind of the same thing, but hustler is a little different to me, because hustling is like you get opportunities when you see opportunities, but a hustle is like you could hustle but not make no money.
Exactly. Mm. That's called hustling backwards.
Yeah.
No, hustling backwards.
It's a lot of cats out here hustling backwards.
But
especially
it's also in LA, called, I'm but, hustling.
But it's also called, but you can also see, it depends on how you see it. It depends on how you see the glass, half empty or half full, because you can see it as hustling backwards, but you can also see it as, you can make as many mistakes as you want, right?
Mm. Real talk.
As long as you keep going. Mm. As long as you keep going.
Keep pushing,
Keep pushing.
So a lot of people see mistakes as failures. Mm-hmm. No, those are lessons learned. If you think about Einstein, if you think about all the greats, Henry Ford, I mean, you can make 100 mistakes, 1,000 mistakes, as long as you keep pushing forward. And you got the determination to win. Mm-hmm. It's called a marathon. It's not called a sprint. So
most
common themes, David.
Wait till you go back and listen
here.
To this show.
Today's
I just laced him with that earlier.
Today's
I said, man, we're not running no sprints. This is a marathon. One foot in front of the next.
Yeah.
Didn't I just say that? Oh, we about to get some bread together.
So you could be hustling. You could be hustling, and shit ain't. Ain't panning out. Excuse my French. Stuff ain't panning out.
No, it's all good.
But it doesn't mean that you failed. It doesn't mean that you failed. It just means you have to pivot and find another way to pivot.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
But you got to stay on your grind. That's what hustling means. Hustling means stay on your grind
every day
until you see the outcome.
Every day you're hustling,
That's really what it's about.
That's really what
an opportunist is, and seeing an opportunity and taking advantage of it. But a hustle is just staying in it, not thinking that first hustle is gonna win.
Yeah, and it's got and not only that though, you got to be willing to put your nuts on the line. You got to be able to lay it all out.
Pause.
You got to put your money. You got to put your money where your mouth is.
You
got to
double down.
Playing.
Yeah,
yeah. You know,
you do.
Like I said, you got to think like an owner. Be a boss.
That's your new tagline. If it's not already,
you know what I'm saying. That's real talk.
That's,
you really got to do that. You know, You gotta like,
and you gotta have fun in the process. Oh, most people take it too serious. Like I gamified my life, so what that means?
I gamified.
Like every day, I just treat my life like I optimize each day to get whatever I need to get done that day.
Exactly.
Done. If I want to go to movies, I do that. If I want to go play pool, if I want to go swimming, if I want to go to the gym, whatever I want to do that day,
I do it.
I ain't thinking about tomorrow. So I'm optimizing. If I'm studying, if I'm researching, whatever I'm doing, I'm getting everything done that day. And then I'm moving on to the next day. So I gamify.
So what's a typical day like in the day in life of Nikko London? Like I know you have your book, and you know you have your fitness stuff. I want to know a little bit about your fitness, and then also you have your music. So
a day in life with Nikko London. It's very interesting because
we're gonna be charging for that. We get ready to charge for that.
Like,
we're
coming back.
We get ready to charge that. No, he's just playing.
Right here. So this
is
what a day in life.
Hey, we never stop on the. I had to learn that. We
you
never
think
stop.
You know me, but you really don't.
Yeah.
All
right, yeah. Hey.
So anyway, most times I'm up at 6 a.m. in the morning. Right, I train early. Right. And then after training, what I do, I formulate, I got things that I got to get done for that day. So if it's jumping on the phone with my manager, if it's jumping on the phone with my agent, if it's jumping on the phone with the book company to strategize different moves and how we got to pivot and what we're doing, these are the things that I do. And also, I get into, you know, my content more, you know, find different videographers to film me, you know, researching that. Maybe going on or Craigslist, putting an ad out. I mean, different things that I want to do
that's
to pivot
right.
to find different
that's
people
right.
to work to get
that's
it done.
Right. Exactly.
Because really, everything is about content right now.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've been driven by is just trying to find different, you know, serious young cats that want to film and get things done.
We got all that for you. We got all the cameras. We got the over the top.
Because that's
we got everything.
Like that's been the biggest thing right now. The biggest thing for me right now is because I need to put way more content up
than what I'm
holding on to. So I got all these brands. I got the fitness brand Zeke Pack that I'm building into like next Nike. And what I'm doing, I'm taking 10 trainers. I'm taking 10 people that I'm training with me. 10 trainers, and I want to train them. I want them to train me for 24 days, at least 30 days, 24 days. And once they get my system and get who I am, then I can have these boot camps throughout the country, and I can send them out there, and I can just remain as the celebrity trainer and just pop up every now and then. But Zeke Pack is the brand that I'm branding. So every time I do a class or whatever, I have this trainer. They be
make money
class.
While you sleeping.
Exactly. So these are the different things that I've been fighting with to get out. And then the music, you know, my EP called The Beginning, Nikko London, The Beginning.
Okay.
You know, it's a 6-7 song EP that I'm gonna put out. You know,
right.
getting ready for that, getting ready, you know, preparing to go on tour for that, figuring out different ways to pivot off of that, how to get in front of certain crowds, how to get on certain
EP
tours.
Is going
to
be fire. I've actually had the pleasure of hearing it.
That's
and
right.
Working.
That's
actually,
right.
We've actually worked together.
Oh, you know V.
No, me and V got it. Hold up.
You
know. Hold up.
V, why are we not listening to that right now?
Wait. We got to get a mix.
Hold up. We got
to. We got
some
fire.
Yo, we got a smash.
Y'all got some fire?
Record. No. Ooh. We got a hit record.
We got
record.
A few smashes.
Y'all got a few smashes? Okay.
Saucin is a smash. Saucin. Anyway, yeah, this record is big, B. Like,
what?
I'm not even exaggerating. You haven't heard it?
I haven't heard it. She didn't even give it to us.
Oh, my God.
You know
why she didn't give it to you? Because it ain't mixed yet.
Yeah, it's not mixed.
We haven't mixed it yet.
Next time.
But the record is, listen to me. I promise you.
It's banana.
The record is bona fide,
you
top
know,
40.
We got to get y'all back here to do that.
Smash.
I got to have that. Because you know we can play it right here and get all your publishing and all that rolling. So we got to get that.
You're going to get it.
We're about to do some business, though. I got some, you know, I'm a creative marketing cat. You know what I'm saying? It's my show, Boss Angeles. You know, I boss up out here.
Boss Angeles. Any Boss Angeles. Yeah. If y'all down with the Boss Angeles show, call in right now.
Yes.
Exactly.
Any questions you want to ask us?
Let's
go. We got Alyson in here.
Exactly.
We got Vonn in the 1-2. Let's go.
Exactly.
Huh?
Let's go.
We got all the time slots in back of us. We got Atlanta, Chicago, New York, Los Angeles.
Let's go.
All of it. Exactly. It's going down.
Miami, Tampa.
And we having fun. So wait a minute. Man, tell us how to get your book. How to follow you on Instagram, Facebook, and all that. You know, give us the hookup so everybody can get you.
Yeah, so you can follow me on Instagram, just Nikko London. Nikko _ London. And then on Twitter is Nikko London. My Snapchat is Nikko the One, though. It's not Nikko London. It's Nikko the One. So NIKKOTHE, the number one.
That's right.
Facebook, you can just follow me on Facebook. Well, you know what? I just started messing with Messenger. So I'm on Messenger heavy now. Messenger.
That's
Nikko
right.
London on Messenger. My business Facebook page is Zeke Pack, so you can follow that. Zeke Pack. I'm doing a lot of ads
on there. Spell that for me.
Zeke Pack. So Zeke Pack is something that I created. So Z-E-E-K-P-A-K.
That's right. Okay. That's right. Social media. Zeke we was just talking about that.
That's
you
right.
got to have your social media back. Yeah.
Can we see the Zeke Pack?
Yeah, of course. You want to see my Zeke Pack?
Can we see the Zeke Pack?
Oh,
you want to see?
Well, go ahead. I ain't mad.
Just saying, you talking about the Zeke Pack?
I hate. Look,
I mean,
it's for you.
That's the camera.
No, I mean, the camera's over there.
Nikko London with the Zeke Pack
workout.
Hey man, I need to go get my workout on. He ain't playing out here. That's right.
Out here getting it.
That's right.
I'm about body weight training. I ain't really into the weights and all that. I really do a lot. I focus on a lot of body weight training.
They say it lasts longer.
Resistant training, body weight training, mixed with cross fitness, mixed with interval training, mixed with strength training as well. So I'm all about tone and shaping your body to the best you can look in your body frame.
That's
so
right.
So if you was to work out with me, I'm going to make you look the best you can look for your body type.
That's right. That's
right?
Because
we all got
that's
different
right.
bone structures. So you
that's
might
right.
look like me.
That's right.
That's what I'm about, making
Man,
you look the best you can look for your
that's
body type.
That's real talk.
You know?
Exactly.
And stay lean, because we all born to be lean. We all, every individual on this planet is born to be lean. Well, none of us is born obese. Mm. So we got to get back to our basic frame of being lean. Mm-hmm. As how you know,
how to
structure.
Eat right,
yeah.
exercise, all
you know what I mean
about that too.
That's what I'm
the
about.
Whole,
that
holistic.
What about us girls like me? I want the thick pack.
The thick pack.
I'm trying to get thick.
I got the booty. I got the booty exercise that's popping
yeah,
off right
now.
Yeah,
but V, you only about a buck 05.
That's what I'm saying.
You ain't about to do more than that anyway. You just go on and break it on down and give thanks for what God gave
all
you.
Right,
all right. Yo, B, you shouldn't be talking. You like a buck 05. You,
yeah. Man, that's why I said I want the thick pack.
You all right, though? You beautiful just the way you are. Don't even trip.
I got the
man.
Butt exercises hey, that's hey, popping. Hey, I got the women
the thick pack.
Butt exercises.
Hey, now, Alyson is a fitness trainer.
Yes,
yeah, and a PR. So, Alyson, you tell us how we can get with you and get your services and all that.
Yeah, thank you. So heartandsoulpr.com, and it's A-N-D spelled out. So heart, like heart, H-E-A-R-T, and soulpr.com. And then you can find that on Facebook as well. Same thing. Insta is Alyson Heart and Soul, but it's A-L-Y-S-O-N, one L and a Y, like Alyson Hannigan.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
Okay.
You heard that?
Be Rich, my host now. She about to get her own show and do her thing. We're going to be going down.
You know.
V texted me the other day. I said, girl, where the hell you been?
Hi, not
yeah. She's hiding out and all those.
No,
all those
ain't no more hiding out.
No, because he just first thing. This is the money man. First thing I do when I pick up the phone, he gonna say, "I'm not even mad. You owe me some money." I said, "Where?"
I don't never forget. I'm like an elephant when it comes to that. Yeah, I don't play when it comes to that.
Like,
but I said, "I'm gonna let that go because we got some other business to take care of. Though we gonna get that."
I swear it's not me. You gonna got the wrong bill with the wrong name and the wrong person. You done paid too many bills.
It's all good. I said every time she talked to me. Either paying a bill or trying to figure out how to get some more to pay a bill.
Hey. Every time.
Yeah, that's the way it be, right?
Listen, man, anytime you talk to somebody, it should be about elevating.
Elevate, always.
Elevate.
That's exactly. anybody, any human.
Exactly.
On whatever
exactly.
level. Money, you know,
life, spirituality,
life.
Relationship.
You can't talk to me about nothing that's upscale, that's uplifting.
Yeah.
I'm gone.
I'm
I heard
gone.
That. No
I'm
negativity.
Gone. I'm gone. I'm
negativity.
Gone.
2017, man.
2017.
No haters. No negativity.
No haters.
We scaling up.
Yeah.
F the
no
haters.
Bones.
Good life.
No
F
bones
haters.
In your yard. No
that's
suckers.
Right.
No haters. Life.
Yes.
No energy vampires.
Freeze.
Oh,
freeze.
But
yeah.
No time wasters.
Yes.
You know
yes.
what I'm saying? No judgmental.
Yeah.
None of that. You know
yes.
what I'm saying? Just
yes.
all love, all positive.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
We're
doing
surprises.
It.
Yes. That's
it's good life.
Right?
Now
yes.
look. Now look. I'm your host.
Heart, a big heart bubble.
Mr. Vonn on Los Angeles today on LA Talk Live. I'm blessed to be doing this. We got our show coming up tonight. Friday Night Live in Studio 11 is going down. We got some artists. We got some food. We got panels. We got beautiful
like
women.
That?
We got Breeze Cakes.
I might perform there
man,
tonight. If,
oh
I, if I pop up,
I'll
I'm
make,
jumping on
man,
stage.
I'll make that happen. We got DJ Goonie. We got DJ Goonie doing the DJ.
Shout out DJ Goonie,
we got
my
a
boy.
Whole stage, the red carpet. I got all my sponsors, man. We got all the mixed drinks. I
might perform
man,
Sexy Bad
it's
Bitches.
Man, going down.
I might perform
real.
Sexy Bad Bitches tonight. I'm feeling
sexy
that right now.
Bad
got
Bitches, my
I
favorite thing.
I
but
like
you know,
this is.
Yeah. Let's go.
Exactly. We go. Bitches.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Nikko, man. I like that. man.
We were having fun this year, man. 2017.
Yeah. Man, it's the year.
All about prosperity.
Man, it's the 1-7. Woo! It's the 1-7. Sevens, baby, sevens.
Y'all understand about numerology?
All sevens.
Y'all understand about numbers?
Me, you came back around. Well, baby, I got you too. Look what you're doing now. Putting all in the stars.
All in the stars.
Yeah, I really do this. You know what I'm saying? Now you really doing it with me. I love it. See, that's my people.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Man, Radio Rich, we want to thank Radio Rich. We want to thank LA Talk Live for making this platform. We don't get censored. We get to do it how we want to do it, you know. It's a broadcaster owned station. We make it happen. We come through. We do the damn thing every time. And I think man, they taught me this game. They taught me the broadcasting game.
You got it.
Yeah, I just jumped in. EP myself.
Yeah.
I executive produced myself.
Yeah.
Boss
up. Boss up. That's how we do it. So Los Angeles every Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific on LA Talk Live. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. We are more than just talk. Where the twist goes down daily, baby. We out.
Yeah.
Oh, what? Oh, the event. Oh, Friday Night Live. Friday Night Live. Studio 11, 4621 Washington is going down tonight. I'm telling y'all, don't miss that. We got the outdoor bar, the upstairs bar, the VIP. Man, beautiful guest performances. We got a lot of stars that's going to be in the line that already RSVP'd. We got the champagne bar. We got the mixed drinks, breeze cakes, and we got a whole special women's empowerment panel in the back. Some of the baddest, most beautiful women you ever seen in your life. Powerful women. It's going down. We out.
Wow.
Gone.
Alone, control our own weather. You and me, suited up, roll it. I don't give a fuck. I like them sexy bad bitches that be cool.
Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. You're tuned in to LA Talk Live, where we're more than just talk.
Girl, you should fuck with me. We can fuck with her. I like them sexy bad. Eat good, nightlife, party on the rooftop. Too sexy for you.